Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Promotion and Pricing Strategies, Chapter Number 13, Part 1. Learning objectives are: discuss how integrated marketing communications relates to a firm's overall promotion strategy and explain the concept of a promotional mix along with outlining the objectives of promotion. Second, summarize the different types of advertising and advertising media. Third, outline the roles of sales promotion in a promotional strategy. Promotion. Promotion's goal is to influence a purchasing decision. IMC, that is Integrated Marketing Communication, allows marketing managers to focus objectives and marketing goals. Promotion is actually the function of informing, persuading, and influencing a purchase decision. Integrated Marketing Communication, IMC, is the coordination of all promotional activities, that is, media advertising, direct mail, personal selling, sales promotion, and public relations to produce a unified customer-focused message. Integrated marketing communications. Based on the objectives, marketers weave the various elements of the strategy: personal selling, advertising, sales promotion, publicity, and public relation. There is one integrated communication plan. So it must take a broad view and plan for all form of customer contact. Integrated marketing communication create unified personality and message for the good, service, or brand. Integrated marketing communication elements include personal selling, advertising, sales promotion, publicity, and public relations. I will explain these elements one by one in the coming slides. Promotion mix. Marketers combine the elements of promotional mix to meet the needs of the firm's target customers. So what is a promotion mix? Promotional mix is a combination of personal and non-personal selling components designed to meet the needs of their firm's target customers and effectively and efficiently communicate its message to them. While personal selling is the most basic form of promotion, a direct person-to-person promotional presentation to a potential buyer, while non-personal selling is advertising, sales promotion, direct marketing, and public relations. Components of the marketing mix. Each component of promotional mix offers its own advantage and disadvantage. If you look at this exhibit, you will see that advertising, personal selling, sales promotion, public relations, and sponsorships have some advantage, as well as these components have some disadvantages. Let's read first one, advertising. Advantages of advertising are advertising reaches large consumer audience at low cost per contact, allows strong control of message can be modified to match different audiences. What is the disadvantage of advertising? Difficult to measure effectiveness, limited value of closing sales. When it comes to personal selling message can be tailored to each customer, produces immediate buyer response. Personal selling effectiveness is easily measured. The disadvantages are high cost per contact, high expense, and difficulty of attracting and retaining effective salespeople. Sales promotion attracts attention and creates awareness. Effectiveness is easily measured, produces short-term sales increases. While disadvantages are difficult to differentiate from similar programs of competitors, non-personal appeal. Public relation has the advantage of enhances product or firm credibility. Personal The public relations creates a positive attitude about the product or company. While disadvantages are difficult to measure effectiveness, it can often be devoted to non-marketing activities. Sponsorships can be viewed positively by consumers. Sponsorship enhances brand awareness. While disadvantages, it is difficult to control message. Objectives of promotional strategies. Every organization has its own promotional strategies. Differentiating the product, providing information, stabilizing of increasing sales, and accentuating product value are all objectives of promotional strategies. Every organization has to follow one of these objectives. Promotional planning. Today's marketers can promote their products in many ways. Product placement and guerrilla marketing are both new and effective marketing practices. Product placement. Marketers pay a placement fee to have their products showcased in various media, ranging from newspapers and magazines to television and movies. You can click this guerrilla marketing website and you can attain further information about guerrilla marketing. Guerrilla marketing is actually innovative, low-cost marketing efforts designed to get consumers' attention in unusual way. Advertising. Advertising expenditures are large in every industry, and consumers receive a massive amount of messages every day. Advertising must find a way to break through. Advertising, if we have to define advertising is a paid non-personal communication usually targeted at large numbers of potential buyers. Advertising expenditures are great. Car makers spend $20 billion per year. Consumers are bombarded with many messages. Firms need to be more and more creative and efficient at getting consumer attention. Types of advertising. Most advertising is product advertising. Institutional advertising includes fundraising events like Walk for the Cure. Cause advertising includes advocacy advertising. The Bill Gates Foundation is dedicated to raising public awareness and generating legislation and other efforts to fight poverty, education, and disease. Product advertising messages designed to sell a particular good or service, while institutional advertising messages that promote concepts, ideas, philosophies, or goodwill for industries, companies, organizations, and government entities. Cause advertising means institutional messaging that promotes a specific viewpoint on a public issue is a way to influence public opinions and legislative process. Advertising and the product life cycle. Firms use different types of advertising during the different phases of the product life cycle. The main goal of advertising is to inform, persuade, or remind, but this will differ in various stages. Let's see how it is different in various stages. Informative advertising is used to build initial demand for a product in the introductory phase of the product. While persuasive advertising attempts to improve the competitive status of a product, institution, or concept, usually in the growth and maturity stages. While competitive advertising compares product directly with their competitors, either by name or by inference. Reminder-oriented advertising appears in the late maturity or decline stages to maintain awareness of the importance and usefulness of a product. I repeat it again. Reminder-oriented advertising appears in the late maturity or decline stages to maintain awareness of the importance and usefulness of a product. Advertising media pie. This pie explains the advertising media that 43%. You can see that the big chunk of this pie is dedicated towards television advertising, that is 43%, 8% internet, outdoor is 3%, magazines 21%, radio 7%, and newspaper 90%. Marketers must choose how to allocate their advertising budgets among various media. All media offer advantages and disadvantages. Marketers must also choose the media appropriate for their message and product. Types of advertising. Advertising executives agree that firms need to rethink traditional ad campaigns to incorporate new media as well as update uses of traditional media. Google is looking at the ways to combine the benefits of internet and TV. Companies spend almost $120 billion on advertising in online and digital media. Television is the easiest way to reach a large number of consumers, and it is most expensive advertising medium. While newspapers dominate local advertising, it is relatively short lifespan. Radio commuters in cars are a captive audience, so internet radio offers new opportunities. Magazines, consumers, publications, and trade journals can customize messages for different areas of country. While direct mail, average American receive 550 pieces annually, high per person cost but can be carefully targeted and highly effective. While outdoor advertising, $5.9 billion are annually spent on outdoor advertising. It requires brief messages. Internet advertising, so a search engine marketing, display ads, classifies ads, etc. These are various types of advertising that a marketing manager can use effectively. Let's look at again online and interactive advertising. I'm talking about types of advertising. Virtual advertising creates a message that is novel or entertaining enough for consumers to forward it to others, spreading it like a virus. Many consumers resent the intrusion of pop-up ads and suddenly appear on their computer screen. Sponsorship. Providing funds for sporting or cultural event in exchange for a direct association with the event. What are the benefits of sponsorship? Exposure to target audience and association with image of the event. Other media options are available to the marketer, such as marketer look for novel ways to reach customers in infomercials, ADM receipts, directory advertising, etc. Not all online advertising is well received. By spreading the word cost to the advertiser, nothing. Marketers are always looking for ways to reach their target markets. Sales promotion. Sales promotion was seen as a supplement to firms' advertising, but it has emerged as an integral part of promotional mix. Sales promotion consists of forms of promotion such as coupons, product samples, rebates, and sporting advertising and personal selling. If you look at the pie, premiums got 57% share in the sales promotion, while samples 2%, games, contests, and sweepstakes 2%, coupons, product, point of purchase displays 23%, and promotional product specialties 7%. Customer-oriented promotions. The goal of consumer-oriented sale promotion is to get new and exciting customers to try or buy products. So it can be done with premiums, coupons, rebates, samples, etc., games, contests, and sweepstakes, specialty advertising. Premiums, coupons, rebates, samples can attract new customers, but focus on price rather than brand loyalty. Rebates increase purchase rates, promote multiple purchases, and reward product users. Three of Three of every four consumers who receive a sample will try it. Games, concerts, and sweepstakes. It can be used in the introduction of new products. It offers cash, merchandise, or travel. Travel is prizes to participating winners. It is subject to legal restriction. Specialty advertising, promotional items that prominently display a firm's name, logo, or business slogan. Trade-oriented promotions. Marketers use trade promotions to encourage retailers to stock new products, continue carrying existing ones, and promote both new and existing products effectively to consumers. Trade-oriented promotions. Sales promotion generated to marketing intermediaries rather than to consumers. You have to keep in mind these trade-oriented promotions are for the intermediary, not for the direct consumers or end users. So it encourages retailers to stock new products, to continue carrying existing ones, to promote both and new existing products effectively to consumers. Thank you. That's all for today's lecture for part one. Thank you.